Yeah, everybody, this is Brother Kingsley. So let me ask you a question. As a Christian, are you playing it safe? Because in this life that we are living, as a child of God, don't play it safe, okay? If you play safe, you're gonna lose. You see? You need to move away from your comfort zone to serve God, you see? Why am I saying this? Today again, the wardens, kind of, the devil used them to disturb me from preaching today in Stratford. I don't know what's going on with some of my black people. You have a power, don't let it get over your head. Every time they see me preaching, they always come, try to prove a point, you know, and I know devil is using them, you see, because the Bible says, the unrighteousness of man suppresses the truth that is in the word of God. So, until someone show me in the paper or even a written law on the phone that I can verify by myself that I'm not allowed to preach with my amplifier in City of London, the country that you call this country a Christian country, I will continue preaching. Listen, I'm not afraid to go to prison. I've been in prison in different many ways in my life. I've been in more than 20 something countries. That's minimum, okay? So they meet their match. I'm not afraid to go to prison for preaching the gospel news of Jesus Christ. And I'm not afraid to die. My mind is made up. Amen? So for all this police and all these wardens, all these people try to intimidate me for preaching the gospel in Jesus Christ, it's not gonna work because they met their match. They met their match. Why did they meet their match? Because first, I'm not afraid of any man talking about any woman. You see? So you wanna take me to prison, that's fine. I will go there, have a good rest, have a good sleep. Once I have my Bible with me, I cannot be bothered. You see, I'll continue there, meditating on the word of God. Because what the devil trying to do here is this. They try to suppress the truth. So I cannot continue preaching in one place. When I decided to start preaching in Stratford, I didn't just turn up there and say, oh, let me just start preaching. Listen, I've been ministered by God to go and preach the gospel in Jesus Christ. As a man of God, that is my duty. The Bible says, preach in season and out of season. But when the things are difficult, you should even preach more. When things are not going well in your life, you should pray more. You see? There's no quitting. No quitting. No devil can stop me from preaching the gospel in Jesus Christ because I am fired up. I got my mind made up. I make my peace with my Lord. Whatever he wants to take me, I've been led by the Spirit. I go and preach. You see? Because look in the life of everyone who serve God faithfully. I mean those who serve God faithfully. You see? They were not afraid of prison. Look at Isaiah, was the man of God. He was sawn into two. Look at Peter, was beheaded. Look at John. John the Baptist was beheaded for preaching the good news, even telling a king, what you are doing is unlawful, taking your brother's wife, Philip. He shouldn't take her. And what happened? He was beheaded for serving God. And I come to preach in London every single time. Police try to intimidate me. Today is another one of intimidation. And I got two guys there, telling them I can preach here because when the Muslim guys come there, they put their table, they put their music, nobody says anything. When people come there to play hip-hop music, play world music, nobody says anything. As soon as they hear the gospel news of Jesus Christ, everybody's fired up. Up in arms. Try to harass me. But listen, they meet their match. Listen, let me tell you one secret thing you need to know. When you give your life to God today, if you're a stubborn person, your stubbornness never go away. Your stubbornness is gonna be now against the devil. You see, I'm a very stubborn person. If you tell me to stop here, I'll continue going in my life in the past. But now that I give my life to God, I am stubborn about sin. If anybody bring anything like sin in my life, I distance the person. I give the person social distances. You see, that includes my brother, that includes my family, that includes anybody that do not know God. I give you all social distances. Why? Because the Bible should not be equally yoked with unbelievers. That also includes your family members. You see? That includes your friend. That includes everybody. You see? So devil tried to intimidate me. It's not gonna work. It's too late. If this was like many years ago when I haven't given my life to God, I can understand. But I have seen the good and the bad and the ugly. I have worked in club. I'm the head security. I later opened my own security company. I got start having people working for me. I have seen the bad, the good, and the ugly in this country. In this life, I've been in countries that I tell you now, you will be shocked. You see? So, listen, the kingdom of God cannot be moved. Amen. I know where my faith is. My faith is on the rock of ages, you see? On that rock, whoever tried to step on the word of God that I'm preaching, the Bible says you will stumble. You stumble over it. Many people have stumbled over it for many years. Why? Because they are not willing to accept it by faith because of what? Their unbelief. You see? And they got all these lukewarm Christians coming to tell me that I can't use my amplifier to preach. I'm asking them, why is it that other people come there to play hip-hop music? People come there to play worldly music. Nobody says anything. That also includes the Muslim guy who come there to play music as well. Nobody says anything. But as soon as I start preaching the gospel of Jesus Christ, people try to shut you down. And I'm not going to accept it. You see, Christ said, if they pursue from this city, move to another city. I will do that once they can show me in the law that I'm not allowed to preach there. But as far as this is a Christian country, I will continue preaching the gospel of Jesus Christ until the law changes in this country. You see, intimidation is not going to work with me. You see, my mind is made up to serve Jesus Christ. No devil can stop me. Until God tells me, my son, come back home. But otherwise, I will continue preaching the word of God. Amen? And that is what I'm in this platform doing. Day in and day out. When I say 24-7, 24-7 means 24-7. Anything that will make me to preach the gospel of Jesus Christ, I will preach it. Nobody can. Nobody can stop it. You see? Because the Bible said the word of God must be preached. He said, how can they hear if somebody do not go and tell them? As I say, who hear our message? So it goes both ways. People are not hearing the word of God. People who hear the word of God, they are not giving their life to God. Listen, the worst thing is going to happen to any life of a believer today is this. God call you and you refuse to come to God. When you die, your punishment is going to be worse for you. Remember the Bible say the judgment will start from what? From the house of the Lord. So that means that will start with the Christian, those who know the truth. The Bible says, if you have a look in the book of Romans chapter 2, when they say about the law, Israel claiming to know the law, it's okay. If you know the law, you are the light to the blind. Make sure that you are using that light to shine in the blind. If it's not shining, God is going to ask you a question. You see? So as a child of God, as a man of God, it's my job to do what? To preach the word. Let me tell you something. In this life, there's something bigger than God. The word of God, the spirit of God in you is bigger than God, bigger than silver. You see, people make me laugh in the Facebook, in the Twitter, in Instagram, in my YouTube video. Some people try to talk about money. I don't need your money. I don't need money in this life. Do you know I have run clubs? I have run nightclubs. I have touched money in my life. I have stolen money before. I have done things with the money. So I give my life to God because I want to serve God. I don't need money. But other days, people think they can buy me with money. But listen, let me say it in this way. The Bible says in the book of Matthew chapter 6 verse 33, see the kingdom of God and his righteousness and everything else will be added unto you. So why should you want to go and seek money? Don't you know that you seek God, the money will start chasing you. You see? And that's the message in this message, is that you must decide who you're going to serve. Are you going to serve God? Are you going to serve devil? You need to make up your mind. You see? Because if you make up your mind to serve God, you don't let anybody tell you otherwise. You don't need any distraction. Your eyes fix on Jesus Christ. Just as I'm driving, my eyes fix on the road. Your eyes fix on Jesus Christ, the author and finisher of your faith. Amen? So the police, they can continue bothering me. I couldn't care less. But I must preach the word. The word must be preached, you see? And that is why I will continue to go to Stratford to preach the gospel of Jesus Christ. Nobody can stop me from doing that, you see, until they still show me in the paper, on their phone, that the law have changed, that I cannot preach there with amplifier. Otherwise, I continue using it because I know the battle is on. You see, many people are demonized. They don't even know it. Why? Because devil is using them. And because of that, they are living in sin. They are being entangled in different many ways. But the only way for you to break away from the devil is what? Is to seek Jesus Christ, to seek Lord, to seek the King of Kings and the Lord of Love. And that is why I wanted to preach today about what Jesus Christ is the way. Muhammad can't save you. Buddha can't save you. No any other religion can save you in this life. Every other door has been closed. Every other way has been closed. That's why Jesus Christ said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. So that means he left only Jesus Christ. So you haven't got any option. You need to come to King of Kings and the Lord of Lords to get saved. You see? If you don't have Christ in you today, you are in crisis. And that is why I preach day in and day out on the social media, in the Facebook, in the Twitter, and Instagram, because the people need to hear the word of God. As a man of God, that is my duty, that is my job. There's no time out. Listen, I want to reclaim all the time I've wasted, 17 years in nightclub, in nightlife, in doing things that I cannot even mention, you see? So this is the payback time for the devil, amen? I want to serve my God from the bottom of my heart, faithfully. The Bible said those who serve God, worship Him, must worship Him what? In truth and in spirit. You see, so I don't want any distraction. I don't want any pullbacks. You see, if someone tried to bring trouble, I just withdraw from that person. As a child of God, that's what you need to do. You see, remember the story about the five wise virgins and the five foolish. There's a message there. You see, you need to get your light burning every single time, day in and day out. Amen. If your light is quenched, that means you have lost the battle. Because you need that oil, you need that Holy Spirit in you every single day. Listen, let me tell you something before I pack up. I just arrived my house. Let me tell you something. If you, as a child of God today, move away from God, if you move away this inch, by the time you come here, it's gonna take you some time. You are here. You need to be here. But if you move down, listen, any one step you make, you are God is distancing you, because the problem is the sin. God cannot withstand sin. Because of one man's sin, everybody sin. Because of one man, righteousness, everybody have righteousness. And that is why you need Christ today. Let me ask you, have you given your life to Christ? Because if you haven't given your life to Christ, today is a good day for you to give your life to Jesus Christ so that you can be saved. Because when you die, don't give your life to God, it cannot make it into the kingdom of God. You see? So remember about my 3 hours, return to God, repent, and remember what Jesus Christ have done in your life, in my life.